big hook that he needs to. Custom must have found a target over here. Former teammate off the edge of the map.
Cut off. He will get the DMX, but he will certainly get DMX to turn. No escape back into it. Mini Divas. Hey, everybody. Welcome. It is the end of the day here. It's stage three. Hex, we've had another great set of games today. You and I got to cast both of the Los Angeles games, and it just so happens that our players of the day come from those matches. So fancy that. It's funny how the world works.
Well, it's a lot easier to call player of the day when you've been able to watch their matches as intently as we did. And I'm going to give it up to my boy Custa in a grudge match today. Of course, he plays for the Valiant now. He used to play for the Dallas Fuel. And not often do you see Mercies with player of the day, but I thought just the value he got out of Valkyrie, barely dying, popping the Valkyrie preemptively to make sure that they got all the healing through, kept his other support alive, just made sure that they were always in a fight and just barely died. And that's all you really want out of your Mercy.
That's the big thing. He's kind of like a soldier, right? Where, you know, you want your soldier, good soldier, he's just never gonna die. He's just gonna stay alive to do damage at all times. That was a big thing for Custa. It's just like, oh yeah, I'm healing everybody forever. And well, I'm just not dying in the process.
And we're finally seeing him level up on those support heroes that aren't Zenyatta, which is where he made his name. He's a great Zenyatta player, but now he has control of the battlefield as the Mercy. He played some Lucio as well, and he's been putting a lot of hours into it.
Yeah, no, that's the versatility for Custa. He's definitely gonna be feeling pretty good about that win today. They won against Dallas Fuel, his old team. He made the right choice, clearly. Unko's over there looking from over the fence. You know, like, I wish I was on the winning side, but unfortunately, that's just not the way it works sometimes. You get traded around and, you know, things happen. I mean, for my guy, in terms of like player of the day, I was thinking more along the lines of Soul. I know that they didn't win, but for me, one of the guys who really made Soul competitive today, despite all of the issues that they had with their backline, you know, speaking of Mercies who were able to just survive forever, felt like Gambler and, you know, Jayhong, Gambler in particular, they weren't quite gelling today. A lot of missed ultimates, a lot of dead ultimates, you know, Valkyrie getting dead within 2 seconds of popping wings, that's no good. So the one player who really stood out for me on Soul was Munchkin, because he just went ham, just taking over maps on a DPS role, totally outstripping every other DPS player on the map. And I think that's a big reason why Soul were even competitive in this series versus the Gladiators, is because Munchkin just decided to go ham.
Especially Junkertown, where we saw the support staying alive. It's very easy for your supports to stay alive when your DPS are killing anyone trying to come at them. And they had such a hard time even engaging on second onto Soul because Munchkin was shutting down pushes before they started.
Nah, he was total beast. I think he was something like 3,000 damage ahead of runner-up at some point, you know, just dropping bodies left and right. So if Soul really were able to stand out today, now obviously some kinks to work out, but Munchkin, he did a lot of work for them, so he'll be my player of the day. So that's going to be it from us, guys. We'll see you tomorrow for more action here at Overwatch League.